There's a all in here. You guys finished all the marikomas, no? I guess it wasn't so long. It's just a point that I wanted to bring out. Then we'll do some of the shoot harashba here. The reason why I brought this whole thing, even though if you look in Aruch HaShulchan, he says that Bichlal, he wasn't marich with this whole sif. Yud Gimel, Ave Keznut, La Keznut, according to Tosfot, according to... Because Bichlal is not so nogia today. People don't get married at that age or whatever it is, especially not before 13. Find somebody to get married already at the age of 13, that according to Kula Alma, according to the Shulchan Aruch,
it was Matsui. Like,
it was Matsui even a generation ago. My grandmother got married at 13.
Because
his grandmother said, 13, 14. Well, yeah, but that's maybe a little bit different. No, it's not Rav Dafka. We say that Tiknu Chachamim Nesuim Lektana. But Rav Dafka is not Bechaye Aviyah, right?
No, this is talking about a Katan before 13. It's a girl. Girls after 12. That's what
everybody said. That's right. Yeah, her father. As long as her father does it, it's fine. If it's her brothers or...
But once she's 12, she can do it herself.
Immune if she wants.
12?
From 12
to the end? From 12? That's only if
a
father.
No, if she's a Nahara, she could do it herself. No, not even a Nahara.
No, a Nahara needs the permission of her father.
That's right.
But when she's past it, when she's a
Bogeret,
she's
12,
her father's
father.
So 12 and a half in a day.
It's fine.
Is either the father or the daughter, so if he both. If one of them.
What, is a Bogeret?
No, Nahara.
Nahara. Yeah, okay, but
one
I also.
The other, if one could disagree.
The whole sugya of Anara is definitely a big sugya in the Gemara. I mean, Okay, anyway, so the point is, what I wanted to bring this out is, what is this whole thing, Maaseh Keznut? In the Rashba, he says, brings an interesting point. Why do we have to see that in other cases, something could be considered Maaseh Keznut? Right? And we'll see it together. But anyways, what's the point we see here in this Rosh here? The point we see in this Rosh?
We see that even though Katan is not, it doesn't have Kiddushim, nonetheless, it's not going to be called Zmut because he's doing it there with Kiddushim. So if you're the Katana, even though the father goes at Midnat Hayam, and there might not be a Kiddushim for a Katana when the father's still alive, nonetheless, it's not going to be called Zmut because it's there with Kiddushim.
And therefore,
so that's why it's called Keznut. No, it's not called Zmut Mamash.
No, so therefore we. That's how you understand it.
Yeah, even though the katan doesn't have.
So no, one second, how does the Shulchan Aruch paskin regarding to less than 13?
But Nara.
This is what we're talking about.
Yeah,
we forgot the Shulchan Aruch. This is what you have to remember. The Shulchan Aruch. This is a problem with all these people pulling. You have to know what the Shulchan Aruch. Ave Keznut before 13.
But the Drisha says Keznut is Manush.
Okay, the Drisha says, the Bar says Keznut, not Keznut. But from this Rosh, Yaakov Banim, and also, did you guys look up the Shulchan Aruch, Lamed Vav? I mean, you guys, you say Lamed Zayin, Ted Vav, right?
Yudalit.
No, it's Yudalit. That's right, Yudalit, sorry. So it seems that the Shulchan Aruch and the Tur are poskining that. No?
You're
allowed. Huh? That kiddushek tana?
It's beseder.
What's beseder?
It's kiddushin.
It's kiddushin? That's how they're asking? It's like the Tosfot, no?
They say no? I thought.
And if you pass him at the end, is it at the stam then? If you pass him this.
That what?
Like
the Tosfot or the Shilta?
Sechin Miyun, no, it's gonna be not like Tosfot. That you need a Miyun. The Tosfot said that you don't need a Miyun.
And Kiddusha Kiddushin?
And if, even though you don't need a Miyun, she lives without it. The Shilta over there said that you need to have a Miyun.
You have the Bet Yosef there?
No.
Just the Shulchan Aruch. Okay, so you open up the Bet Yosef, Lamed Zayin. You saw the Bet Yosef inside?
Yeah.
You saw the Bet Yosef inside?
Somewhere the Rosh inside.
So a bit of the. So what does the Shulchan Aruch say? Stam ve'yesh.
Stam ve'yesh.
So the stam is like
stam
what?
Stam ve'yesh l'tot and the yesh l'chol
be'l. And the yesh l'chol be'l. And the yesh l'chol be'l. Okay, so if you look in the Lamed Zayin Yudalid.
That is fine.
Right. The go, huh?
Okay.
The what?
So
whether you say it according to the Shilta or the Tosfot, right? At the end of the day, is it Maaseh Znut?
No.
It's not Maaseh Znut. That's what the Rosh, because we see that the Rosh compares the Kiddushe Ktana just like the Kiddushe Gdola. Just a Tamtzit here. If you look in the Bet Yosef, this is the Lashon of the Rosh. It's very bekitzur here compared to the Rosh over there is a little bit more be'arichut, right? Ilchach nira de'en la nisuin ve'afilu midabaranan. So, Aktana according to the Rosh, and according to the, like he passing like the Tosfot, en la nisuin, bichlal, right? Because why was the whole din of the Sheilta and the Bahag? Initially, the Rosh wanted to say maybe there's a machloket between the Bahag and the Shilta, and there's really his kiddushin. So he says no. According to the Bahag, it seems that it's only when the father shachav, right, when he passes away, and therefore the Shilta says what. So the, according to this is a contradict to the Shilta. He says no. It could be that mi'ever layam means that it's the same thing. It's compared like the same thing. On the other hand, the Tosfot says no. At the end, bechlal nisuin. As long as the father is alive, he could. Why?
Why? Because the maskara is Shema Yikadesh.
Shema
Yikadesh ota b'midat hayam. And if she stays with someone over here, or Shema Kadesh, Shema Kidesh ota. And then therefore, if
Shema Imche, no, Shema Kidesh ota.
Kidesh ota b'midat hayam. And then the Meila, when she's going to be,
according to
her,
not necessarily, but it's tchuya. Rabbi Adam doche it. Shema Kidesh. But the point is Shema Imche Avia. If her father, if her mother, her brother, do the kiddushim, whatever layam, is a safek that when he comes, Shema Imche Avia. So as long as it's in
the Rosh is dochei that, it's not
that what?
It's not a chashash. Because if the chashash was Shema Imche Av, then that means
why?
What was it chia again? If the chashash is Shema Itche Av,
but she still eats truma.
That's the Ran already.
Was the Ran already?
Yeah, that's the Ran. According to the Ran, it seems that Shema Imche Avia. Okay, akopanim. So according to the Tosfot, we see that what? It's not kiddushin akidushim. But akopanim, he says that even according to Tosfot, and even according to the Shilta, this is even though we don't, there's no tikkun of kiddushin. Mikol makom en la asra mishum shetechashev kepnuya veomedet. Why? It's not beznut. The kavan, the derech kiddushim v'nisuim nisuim yetzlo. And the znut. Midi davar katan. Now he compares to a katan. She siyav aviv dalo chashiv kilo beznut. It's not filu gedola v'bat onshin. Af agav de'elzuk nirabanan nisuim kedetan perik aisha. Aisha rabba perik ben tet shanim shenasa aisha p'tura mi'elachalitza v'minaybum v'ata lefi alachot gedolot tzicha mi. Okay, this is the point here. The point here, so it seems that this is a contradiction of what we're saying in our Shulchan Aruch. This is why I wanted to bring it out a little bit. It's a small point, but it seems that it's contradicting what the Torah in Shulchan Aruch says here. Because even if you say that Shulchan Aruch, Stam Ve'yesh, is posek like the Shilta, according to this Rosh, the Shilta would be maskim that if she was married, it's not Maaseh Znut.
That's
a pshat
kiznut.
Huh?
That's
of what keznut?
It's not with mamash, the keznut.
That's the answer to the Ramah.
That's the answer to the Shulchan Aruch. That's it. That's it.
That what?
That there's no stira. The Shulchan Aruch didn't call Amyut Gimel Znut. He called it keznut. Why is it keznut? Because the Maaseh is no kiddushin. Even though it's not called znut because it's derech kiddushin, but it's not going to be. It's not going to be. It's not
okay. Good. So what? You're saying that's why he wants to say keznut. Okay, that's only the Bach says that. I'm saying in the Bet Yosef itself,
yeah.
According to the Rambam and everything, it's Maaseh Znut. keznut. Okay, somebody wants to be medayek in the kaf adimayon, it's keznut. But according to the Shulchan Aruch and everything, it's you look at the Bet Yosef, according to the Ram, Shitat Rambam, it's maaseh znut, lechora. Okay, according to the Tosfot, bichlal is not a question. According to the Tosfot, bichlal not a question, right? Because he says even before, afilu mitzvah ka'avid, right?
Yeah.
So there are some. I saw somewhere somebody wants to say that in the Shulchan Aruch here, he wants to say this is talking about la'asil lechatchila. Not Shulchan Aruch. They want to say that avek kiznut is if you want to do it lechatchila. Lechatchila, one, everybody agrees that you should not marry off your son when he's less than Yud Gimel Shana. Why? Because it's maaseh kiznut. Now, if he's already get married,
no problem.
The rabbi, if he's already married, if he's already done it, we're not going to say that now it's maaseh znut. Why? Because again, according to this Rosh, this is how it seems that the Tur and the Shulchan Aruch are also passing. According to this, it's not because she had slob and nisuim, and therefore it's not a problem. So again, the Shulchan Aruch, when he says keznut, without getting to this whole diuk of keznut, it's only saying that echatchila you should not marry in less than 13. But if you do it, it's not a problem. This is one of the tirutzim that they give. Okay, we're gonna do the Rashba inside now. What's nogea to us? You guys have the Rashba? I don't have the Rashba. Do I have it? Oh yeah, I have it. So what's nogea to us? What's nogea to us over here a little bit? Okay? So the point is, if you look in the Shuda Rajma Taf Gimel, he brings out a point here. What's Nogat to ask him? He says the point that obviously the Tosfo don't say, and this he's going according to the Shidata Darambam, right? That Kiddush Nisuin Echad Lo Tikno Rabbanan LeNisuin Ave Maaseh Znut. So he says like this: Shalta Alinyan Katan Shisiu Asher Amarta Ma Chashash Yesh Badavar. Right? What's the Chashash Bichlal A Katan Shisiu? Be'emet Asur LaAsot Ken Mikama Tamim. Chad Adekol DeLo Tikun LeRabbanan Nisuin Bilad Znuti. First thing, okay, and we see and we know that in the Bash, he already says according to Tosfot that's not a problem. It's not maaseh znut. According to the Tosfot, is the maaseh znut lo tiknu rabbanan? No. Begdula mizor shenu beeva mot. Okay, he brings a raya from a perik bet shamay and memanin el arusot u'natam azeh amru leokum ta deraba v'rav Yosef. V'ad kan lo ke'amru bet ilal ben arusot ben esuot u'mfarash ta'amayu כיוון דאיקה קידושים לא עטו למימרא דבילת זנות היא, אלא דאיקה למימר, דאיקה נשואי דרבנן. אבל כאן דאיקה נשואין כלל בילת זנות ממשי. אוקיי, so over there in the Gemara, there's a machlok between בית שמאי and בית הלל. הכל פנים, the whole חשש over there is whether somebody is going to say it's מעשה זנות. So according to the Rashba, he wants to say that wherever there is נשואין, there's not a chashash of shmua maaseh znut, but whenever there's not nisuin, like in our case, is maaseh znut. There's a chashash of maaseh znut. Where are we getting to? Now, afilu bepochet lebetula mimatayim velalmana mimane asru min hachashash azeh shema taaseh bihilata bihilat znut. So if he's pochet, this is a little bit where it's nogea a little bit. The whole nekuda, whether it's considered maaseh znut or not maaseh znut. If he's a pochet for a betula less than a matayim, or a almana less than a mane, there's a chashash of maaseh znut. Why? Because she's going to think that she's kala be'enav. So she's kala be'enav, v'chem b'meshayet ishto, sha'a achat b'lo k'tuva, af al pi shu chashash rachok, שמה יתיר שתהיה קלה בעיניו להוציאה או שמה יכפור בכתובתו ומתוך כך מתכוון בבילתה בילת זנות ואף על פי שהיא אשתו גמורה כל שכן וכל שכן בזו שהיא ודאי בילת זנות. Here we have even a חשש of בילת זנות when he's not when he's not conducting himself according to halacha in regards to giving the betula matayim and a almana mane, right? Why? Because she's thinking that maybe he's mezazel ba, he's not taking her seriously, right? That's right. Shetiya kala ben avlotziya. And therefore, she's mitkaven that beilata beilat znut. And this is in a case where she's married to him. And therefore, when he's not giving her the proper needs, right? Or whether it's a mane or it's a matayim, it's still chashaz shema she's mitkaven she beilata znut. In other words, she's not bedat to be married to him. And whatever she's doing it beilat znut.
Her or him?
It's her, because she's not giving. No.
Poiches l'bisul l'cher v'shem, no?
Yeah, he's pochet, and therefore she's mitkaven l'bilat znut. Mikochka titkaven bilata bilat znut. Oh, you're saying lav davka, it's him?
No, I'm talking about
lav davka. Oh, okay, good. I thought he was talking about her. Bilata bilat znut. Lav al bishi, ishtog mura.
No, but here it's bilat znut, not
bilat znut. Where?
It's always Bilasa.
I have Bilasa. Why you have Bilasa?
Right, yeah, so usually it's talk about the lady.
That's the way I understand it. Chaim, you understand what's going on here? Why? He's saying something like this. If the kavana, if there's no kavana, when he's not giving her a mane or a matayim, so there's no kavana lechorav kiddushin of the Be'ilah itself, even though he's married, but he, because she thinks she's kala be'enav, she's not mitkaven 100%, and therefore the Be'ilah itself, if it's not l'shem kidu, if it's not l'shem nisuin,
don't kill her Be'ilah.
Huh?
Don't pass it on the kavanah shalah.
Al mi?
Kavanah shalah
yisha. Lama?
Hu akoneh,
lo hi. Ah, but tzich da'at koneh, ma, bekol kinyan tzich da'at koneh. What's it? אתה יכול להכריח אותה ועל כך לא בכל קניין צריך דעת קונה שצריך לקנות את עצמה. And then also when you come to the Be'ila, if she thinks that maybe she's not so worth for him, and therefore she doesn't see herself as her as his wife, and therefore every Be'ila could be kebe'ilat znut, as long as he doesn't give her the ktubah, he doesn't have a case where he doesn't give him a time with the ktubah. Afa pi she ishto gmura, even though she's 100% his wife, nevertheless it could be considered a bilazon. So he wants to learn for this even more so in such a case, right? In a case where there's not even nisuim here. Kol sheken. Okay, this is again all going according to the Shita of the Rambam, and because according to the Tosfot altogether, it's not a question here. Right? What do you think? What are you saying, Levi?
No, I'm saying for the end of the Shiva.
What? Okay. Okay, a few things I want to also ask. Bichlal, somebody asked, I forgot to look it up, but it seems that there's a question. Why in the din of kfiya, right? Bichlal, if anybody looked at the Rambam, anybody look at the Rambam?
Yeah.
You looked at the Rambam and Perek Tedvav, you shoot, right? No, that's what we just spoke about, the Yisur Rebiya. But in Tedva Bishut, we saw it a few times, right? This is the whole dinim in our Shulchan Aruch. So, Bichlal, there are a few differences. I wrote down this Rambam, where did I put it? I wrote down the whole Rambam. There's a few dinim in the Rambam There's a different Leshonot, right? I wrote a few differences that there is. Bichlal, the Rambam doesn't bring this whole din. It seems that in the Ar Shulchan Aruch, mitzvah min ha-mufchar, to get married, 13. Good. The Rambam doesn't bring it. זה לא מובא בכלל ברמב"ם. דבר ראשון. Second of all, another thing that I saw in the Rambam, the whole din of כפייה, not mentioned once in the Rambam. The whole Rambam, not even mentioned once. You look at the פרק ט"ו, he said, the whole סעיפים, סעיף א', ב', and ג', or a whole in פרק ט"ו, א' and ב'. האישה, האיש מצווה על פריה, על פריה ורבייה, אבל לא האישה. Good? ממתי יש נדחה מזווה זו? מבן 17. Okay, there, we saw that. What, mean, what does he mean בן 17? The magid says that it's 17 שלמות, but he thinks the real נוסח is 18, right? וכיוון שעברו 20 שנה ולא עשה אישה, הרי זו עובר ומבטל מצוות עשה. Did we see that in the Shulchan Aruch? What? It's also a thing. It's not brought down in the Shulchan. What does he say? What's the lashon of Shulchan Aruch? Va'ikar shelo ya'acher. Okay, this is already Sif Dalet in the Shulchan Aruch. V'im haya osek betorah v'tarut ba v'ha mityareh. Okay, so I saw three differences. If anybody could see any more differences, I saw three differences in the Rambam. First of all, he doesn't mention Yud Gimel, mitzvah min ha-mufchar. Second of all, there's no din of kfiya. It's not mentioned once. Who brings the whole din of kfiya?
Ramban
or the Rosh?
Or the Rosh?
Right, but in the Shulchan Aruch, it's brought down as the Rosh, no? That's what I remember in the Tur.
Yeah.
In the Tur, right?
Yeah,
he says that Adonai Avi Arosh. Shavak, Shelo, Ratzah, right?
There's
no din of kfiya. And then another thing is, what did we say? Mevatel mitzvat aseh. Okay, so in regards to Yud Gimel, Abba Ben Shimon, I asked Rabbi Ben Shimon, and he said that the Rambam goes to one shita. It's not brought down. It's not. It's only a ma'aseh of Abaye, right? Gere besatina. He doesn't bring this down. Why didn't he bring the din of kfiya? So the Rogo Chover says, what is the Rogo Chover says? How can you be kofe on such a thing? How can you be kofe on something that he doesn't want? We know that there's a din, kofim ala mitzvot, right? A bad din can be kofe at shetiten of show. And this is what the Ran writes.
Right.
The Ran writes, at certain age, if he doesn't do it, makim oto at shetiten of show. But how do you kofe on that? If he tells, yeah, I don't want. איך אתה כופה על אותה אישה? תקבי מקיים המצווה of לולב. You don't want to do it. We'll beat you until you want to do it. And take this lulav. What does he care? This lulav, that lulav. But the Isha, how can he be kofe on him to what? To get married to this girl? Or get married to this girl?
There's all three of us to get married.
That's right. And that's why a lot of the poskim, like the Aruch HaLechem, a lot of poskim, right, that this is what it says. Also, the thing that we're not kofe, this is the heter of today, people don't have kofe. Because he could say, I'm looking for a better shidduch. This is what the Ramah writes. Looking for a better shidduch. But are you going to kofe on what? How can you kofe on something? This is a big... the Rambam himself doesn't bring this.
Well, how does he talk to this?
Who?
Clayton Ezer.
Good question. I don't know. The Rambam doesn't hold that. Okay, so what was the second? The third one was what?
Mitzvat
Aseh. Mitzvat Aseh. Okay, so Mitzvat Aseh, I was a little bit disturbed with this whole thing, and I found something. Maaseh Rokach. It's Rabbi Mesod. I don't know how I found this. Maaseh Rokach, Rabbi Mesod ben Moshe, or something like that. Where does he bring this from? The Rambam. That he's over on Mitzvat Aseh. Maaseh Rokach, it's at the bottom, the Kevan. You guys see it?
the cave on Shavuot.
Yeah, it says like this. Mikivan she'avru chav shana bekidushim. Huh?
When did he go? Before the Rambam?
No, he's on the Rambam. He can't be
before. Oh, on the Rambam, ah. Huh? Okay.
No,
I thought you were saying that the Rambam is
bringing from him. No. Okay, so what's the makor here of the Rambam that is over on Mitzvah Aser? Bekidushin dechavted amar Rava. Chen tana deber Rabbi Ishmael ad kav shana yoshev bekashuchu ומצפה לאדם מתי יישא אישה. כיוון שהגיעו אחר ולא נשא אומר טיפח עצמותיו. עד כאן. רבנו עתיק, הרי זה עובר ומבטל מצוות עשה. Where does it say even in the Gemara that he's over on Mitzvot Aser? Hashem is just waiting for you. Okay, he's saying to me, I'm Mevatan Mitzvot Aser. Because it's also interesting. How do you explain this, Rambam? Mevatan Mitzvot Aser is why? Like it's a Mitzvah Nimshechet. It's Mitzvah Shena Overet. And maybe you could say also, by the way, that's why in Limud HaTorah, why can you be, you could learn and not get married? The mitzvah shena overet. What do you mean? I can get married when I'm 89. Unless the guy dies, you know, but... why is that mitzvah shoveret? It's not mitzvah shoveret. נראה שהוציאו ממה שכתב... Oh, this is what he writes. שם רב אונה לתעמד אמר בן 20 שנה ולא נשא אישה כל ימיו. בעבירה
כעבירה
שנה ולא עשה אישה כל ימיו כל ימיו בעבירה בעבירה עשה כל דעתך אלא אימה כל ימיו בערעור עבירה. עד כאן. This would go amazing according to the Bash, by the way. According to the Bash, remember? So Sefer Mishum Mishum Iru Ravera, right?
Yeah.
So was according to the Bash, Kashim Iru Ravera Miavera. The Bash would be Echoira. Kashet, the Mishnah has a Nigel Shani, Velani Shanit Heber Chol HaMitzvot. What?
He also holds the Kashi. The Bash doesn't say he doesn't hold the Kashi. He just says that we're not Kashi.
Good. Beautiful.
No, we're not Meicher. We're only Meicher.
Yeah, that's right. Be Mekayim. Good. But even more so to the Cham, because the Cham says we're also to be La'atzil min ha'avera, we also do.
That's just a shita.
Right.
Nothing to do with if it's an avera or not, or how much.
Right, 100%. וקשה דמי שנכנס ל-YBG משנים ואלא שנתחייב בכל המצוות נתחייב גם במצווה זו ולמה נייחס לו אבון הירו עד זמן זה. You understand what he's saying here? At the age of 13, he's already chayav to this mitzvah. Okay, so we're going to be meyaches the hirura aveira from Yud Gimel until Yud Chet. In other words, why are we waiting until the age of 18 or the age of 20? V'may iria me'esrim ve'ela. Ela v'day delidyan mitzvah zo lo nechshav ke bitula ad zman shema'anishim mi'bet din shel ma'ala. When is it considered that you mevatel the mitzvah? Is when you reach the age where bedin milamala manishim oto. Da'ainu ben 20. All the bedim look like chafim here. Da'ainu ben 20. The darkei adarkei noam k'tiv. Ach delinyan irur al kol panim chashinan. What is this?
Haze.
חסין הזה, אלא עד... חשינן...
לא.
אלא שעד 20 אין שולטים בו כל כך. אה, so he's saying, we're choishes to this because until the age of 20, the Ihurim, he doesn't have so much. From the age of 13 to say, בכלל, until is it. So according to the Rambam, according to this, what did the Rambam say that he's mevatel mitzvot aser?
What?
So how did he just meyash of this?
He said it's
Shalom Ravona. Huh? Shalom Ravona. ודא שהרן זל סיים דאם לא רצה לישא אישה.
So you have to get married because you can't have a hero of it. That's what he said.
Right.
So that's not an assay. It's a mitzvah, whatever. It's something you have to do, but it's not an assay. It says bitul mitzvah assay. That's what the Rambam said, right?
Good, yeah.
But it doesn't, but it's not, it's miyasha, but it's not miyasha of Rambam.
Yeah, but the Iruya Avera is not, it's also not a.
It's
also a lo ase, a lo ta ase. Irure avera?
That's what I'm saying. It's not a ase.
No, but who says irure avera is a lav? Veda sha'aran zal siyem. Deim lo ratza lisa isha makin oto ad shetitze nafsho dumya deshar mitzvot ase. Okay, so Aran finishes off that we are koifa on this. Nachilami, there's a big question here. What does it mean? Is mevatel mitzvat aseh? The mashma and the Rambam that mamish mevatel mitzvat aseh, right? But according to this, it's not mashnas. I don't know. Still, I don't know if it's still meyashev 100%. It's not meyashev 100%. Even according to what, even without what you're saying,
mm-hmm.
How is it? Even after the tirutz, he's only it's like ke'avera, ke'irure avera. It's like he's be'avera. But how is it nogea to the mitzvah taseh itself? How is it nogea to the mitzvah taseh itself?
What do you mean? Because that's how you save yourself from.
What?
You save yourself.
So you're saving yourself from. You're saving. So it's only to save yourself.
Yeah, but that's part of the you know life. You gotta. It's like a service. It's more of a lav than an aseh. That's what I'm saying. If you say it's a lav, then it's fine. Then it makes sense. Like a suro. Yeah. Panam, what do you say? Huh? Like a suro.
Yes.
That's what you're saying here, right?
I think you had the mitzvah say of getting married.
And what mitzvah say?
I got the Rambam we saw. Yeah. It's massively to do to Likuchin.
Yeah.
Huh?
What?
I got the Rambam.
So what's this question, Michal?
Don't worry about the Davka at a certain point.
You should be righteous with your God.
It's like you mevatel a mitzvah taseh in order to save you from a mitzvah lo taseh. Okay, it's a chiyun on this. Okay, last thing. Is it already time? Is it? We're way past the time, no?
Yeah.
Look at that.
10 minutes over time.
Okay, the lekach tov, you guys can look at it. It's in Hamakom Ayudalid, right?
Mm-hmm.
Lekach tov, here. Hamakom.
Any Talmud Ha'Avrich.
Yeah.
It's a Chaim David Reif.
Yeah, it's interesting. He basically, his shita is that we could skip to the point. Here, look, three lines from the bottom of La'arich before Ve'od Ayen, Barambam, right? He says, Ve'al Kochecha, you see it?
Mm-hmm.
יש חיוב המצווה גם לפני זמן המצווה. כן, דברי התלמוד, ויפה עיר ויש לו בזל, ועוד אין ברמב"ם פרדל, בישות חב"ד שכתב, וזה לשונו, האיש מצווה על פריה ורבייה, אבל לא האישה. ומתי האיש נתחייב במצווה הזו? מבין 17 שנה. ובהגותיי לרמב"ם כתבתי ת' זין, כתבתי על זה וזה לשונו, וזה לשוני. אני רוצה לומר שנעשה בן י' ג' להתחייב במצווה זו על נישא אישה כשיהיה בן י' ח'. So he has a chiyuv now to get married when he'll be 18. What's the nafkamina? He has to prepare from since he's the age of 13.